had to lower this down a little bit. The camera was sitting up so high. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Joyce, Joyce All Knowing Tarot. And it's Saturday. Is it Saturday morning? Yeah, it's Saturday morning here. I hope everyone is having a fantastic Saturday. I leave on my vacation on Monday. And so I said, let me just squeeze in a video here. Couple of things I want to talk about first, but I've got some things I want to look at specifically. So the couple of things I want to talk about was in the comments. It was regarding the live that Linda and I have done. Let me just be clear that I just don't know Linda from the internet. I know Linda. You know, we talk on the phone or we text or what have you, or we email. We're not strangers, okay? A couple people were like, oh, you don't watch her or you don't know she did lives. Listen, I started watching Linda a long time ago, which I think I let that be known when she was working with, she appeared on Third Eye Champagne. If you watched the internet for a minute, you know who Third Eye Champagne is. And it went from there with me when she started her channel. I was right there, all of that. I enjoy her completely, never thinking that she was going to reach out to me and say, hey, let's work together. And that's what happened. And we've been working together. We enjoy each other. Our energy combination is just great. You know, some people you just combine with and you gel with. A couple of people were saying, oh, it seemed it was frantic or whatever. Listen, the day before we met on a Thursday, Wednesday, my spirit was saying, oh, something is not right. Something's not right. And early, I couldn't tell what it was. Just thinking about her and I had this real strong pull that something was not right with her. And then early Thursday morning, which is the day we did the live, she said that things were kind of hectic her way. Can we back it up instead of 2 to 2:30? I said, sure. And then she ended up being late, but not something that she planned. It was because she was doing something else, and then she got caught up in traffic. She went one way, she was caught in traffic. She went another way, she was caught in traffic. She can't plan the traffic. By the time that she got on camera, well, we're not on your side, when she came into the recording studio that we're in, she had a headache. She had not eaten all day, and she was a little bit, trying to get ready for me. And what I'm going to do is offer her and myself grace. It is easy to criticize anybody, but when we offer grace, that gives that person the permission, as it will, to be human. And we're all human. And I think she did a fantastic job. And that's why she was eating a sandwich, for those people bothered by that. She'd already taken something for a headache, she told me. And so I think ultimately it was a really good combination, as it usually is. And we'll be dealing back again more than likely next month. So please give us grace. The other thing I want to mention was someone said to me, and I almost find it funny, I'm just going to say, when I said to them about the dream, I talked about the dream I had with the comedian Paul Mooney. Either you guys don't know who that is, or you do know who it is, I'm not really sure. No one mentioned anything about that. But then when I talked about OJ, there was somebody who wrote in my comments that I've lost all credibility with everybody because I said that OJ did it. I'm here to tell you, I'm standing by that. My visions are what they are. And I just was sharing them with you. This crime happened so long ago. It just happened that I wanted to share it with Linda and you guys could be privy to it. I'm standing on my truth the same way I did after the chase, which someone corrected me was on the 91, not on the 5, which is just west of the 5. But anyway, I'm standing on that. They couldn't change my mind back then. They're not changing my mind now. This is a female, thought that I must have been insane, literally, saying that because he was an ex-football player and he had bad knees. I could care less about any of that. I do know that based on his astrological placement, when I saw that vision, that I went to check that out, yeah, it was more likely that he did it than anybody else. That's number one. But number two, when you are seeing something that you can't control, and he was a very much a control freak. He was at the height of his celebritydom. He was making movies and being on talk shows and the Playboy Mansion and all of that stuff that comes with it at the time. You couldn't tell him anything. And so even if he divorced his wife, that his wife still belonged to him in his mind, not the truth of it. And so when you see something you don't like, your adrenaline pumps. And then you hear about people who, you know, are seniors and lifting up cars off of people or doing these amazing feats because your adrenaline gets so pumped up. So that part. So whoever the person is that wrote that, I hope that you see this video, because the same way back then when people were saying to me, OJ didn't do it, OJ didn't do it, yada, 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 even the jury acquitting him. Which after the fact, the jury said they only did that because of the all the riots and stuff, and because the LA police got off for beating Rodney King, that part. So I just want to let that be known that just like the way I said it back then, and I stand on that as I'm saying it right now, it wasn't something I made up. It was a vision that I had. So I just want to say those things so people can understand that we're human. We enjoy each other. I don't watch other channels of people now and then, but I really don't, only because it's influence. It's like if I'm, because I'm a longtime teacher, it's like if I'm supposed to be in my class teaching, but I'm always in everybody else's class trying to see what they're doing. If I'm always seeing what they're doing, what am I doing in my class? Probably not much. So everyone brings their own style, their own variety, their own choice. It's our own choice in everything that we do. And that's the thing about this life. So some things I want to say, and by the way, happy Juneteenth Day. It is official federal holiday. Here's the interesting part. Juneteenth has been going on all this time. It is not new. If you live like I was born in Milwaukee, raised there until about 18, Juneteenth was still something that was going on when I'd come back and visit my family. Juneteenth would happen on Juneteenth. On used to be 3rd Street. If you're from Wisconsin, you know what I'm talking about. It turned to MLK. Juneteenth in Vegas, they would celebrate that on the West Side. It is nothing new whatsoever. And to have it recognized is fantastic. However, Trump said if it wasn't for him, nobody would ever known about Juneteenth. Yeah. I find that hilarious. Trump did not make Juneteenth. It was not Trump had anything to do with Juneteenth. Juneteenth had been going on for a long time. Trump also said that the black voters are not going to vote for him. They hate him. And that's not my feeling at all. Yes, the majority of black voters, those that vote, will not be voting for Trump no matter what he runs for. But there's also a percentage of black voters that will absolutely vote for Trump and still feel like he was a good president. I've even seen some black young men saying that Trump was a better president than what Biden is doing, irregardless of the fact that Biden just put a total of, I think it was almost like $5.3 billion of student loan forgiveness. He did one part at the beginning of the year and he did a second part the other day. So those people, especially if you went to ITT Tech or things like that, your loan was forgiven. So that part. So black voters overall, those that vote, people of color that vote, will not vote for Trump if he ran for 2024. But don't make that the excuse that you don't run, because you were talking all that before. So another thing I want to share with you was, and I'm going to take a look at Jared and Ivanka and Betsy DeVos today. I'm just curious. But evidently, these people were making all kind of money on the side. So Ivanka and Jared, they made, I had to write it down so I can remember the dollar amounts. They supposedly made somewhere between 172 to 640 million on the side while working in the White House. Betsy DeVos made on the side $225 million while working in the White House. And Trump made, it was estimated like $1.6 billion of money while working in the White House. This was the best thing that ever happened to them. And oftentimes, what do they say? Thieves always come back to the scene of the crime. So would he like to run again? Yeah, if he knew he was going to get that kind of money. And then also, I like to say the girls are fighting. Mitch McConnell is really pissed off at Trump. Well, Mitch McConnell never liked Trump to begin with. He liked the Republican Party being in control. He liked being in power. He's never going to be the majority leader again. He can kiss that goodbye, even though he would do anything in the world to be and even act as if he is, and he is not. And Schumer needs to step up a little bit more, my thoughts. But McConnell is upset because Trump is out here endorsing these people who were GOP people but were part of the insurrection and who were really nut jobs. So he wants those people, he wants those people to get their positions back. And the thing about it is, the more Trump talks about these people, maybe the less chances that they have to hold office. I'm using the Murder of Crow deck today. Just want to take a look at, so I'm going to look at Ivanka and Jared. I'm going to look at Betsy DeVos. You know how she has gotten real quiet, like she took the money and ran with it. I bet you, good grief, Ben Carson. I bet he didn't get much money on the side. His wife bought a, what was it, a table or a lamp or something, and it was a big fuss made out of that. So, yeah. So what is, now someone in the live said that they were told Jared would have an ankle bracelet. So what's happening around Ivanka and Jared? I'm just going to do a quick three spread, make it as random as I possibly can. I'll do that by laying them, spreading them out. Let's see. Jared and Ivanka. Jared and Ivanka. Jared and Ivanka. Oh, today is my cleanup day today. Let me turn this light on here. I wanted to be right in the sun since I moved my location. Knight of Cups, Queen of Wands, and okay, so for them, I see them both right here. We have the Knight of Cups. Knight of Cups is the type of person that comes and they promise you the world. Can you see that? They promise you the world and what they're going to do and what they're going to offer you. And they do that for a minute, but they can't hold that up. They're very emotional individuals. And even though he looks like a Frankenstein or somebody that's a cold fish, no. He is a more of an emotional person than what we realize. We can't just go off of what his sun sign is. We have to look in the chart deeper. And I hope people are starting to really understand that it's not just your sun sign. It's just one part of you. He is more emotional. This whole rift that he has with his father-in-law really is bothering him. He's not the type of person that says, okay, it's whatever. No, it really bothers him. And then we have Ivanka standing right next to him. There she is. She's the Queen of Wands. And Queen of Wands, people like her. People like her. They think that she's attractive. They're drawn to her. She's got kind of a magnetic personality, to be honest about it. And especially as it comes to business. She's the businesswoman. She's really the brains behind the situation. Yes, he was real estate with his dad and all of that good stuff. She's the brains behind it all. She's the one that keeps him going in the right direction as it comes to anything else. But as I see for both of this couple together, the brains and the emotions, I have the Hermit card for them. This is the Hermit card. Let's see if you guys can see that. Yeah, they are going quiet. They're being very quiet. They're really keeping to themselves. The Hermit is really about introspection. Like, they're really thinking about everything that happened and their role in it. There's fear that they're trying to manage or master, okay? Ivanka can do that. She has the energy the sort of wherewithal, the knowledge that says, I know how to do that. I know how to keep my energy right, so I'm not. It's him. It's her trying to prop up her husband to keep him calm, you know, so we don't manifest the worst of the worst. Yeah, they're trying to just keep continue to move on into the direction that they're going. They've got a lot of money. This is Seven of Pentacles, and they're trying to figure out what their best move should be as it comes to their money and their finances. They got a lot of advisors and things going on, and they really just want, this is the Ten of Pentacles. They want to be like a legacy. So I don't see Jared getting arrested. I don't see him with an ankle bracelet on him. I really don't. I see him trying to get his emotions together because he's a little bit hurt behind everything. He is. His father-in-law has, as we all know, a very nasty mouth. He can be very nasty, a very vengeful, very gossipy, and it's almost like he's trying to ruin his son-in-law's reputation. And so Jared feels a way about that. So right now, I don't see Jared or Ivanka doing anything other than trying to estate plan, if that makes sense. Try to get their money in situations right. They want to create a long-term legacy. And I thought that they might end up being breaking up, but not at all. No. I'm just looking at them one more quick time. No, they're looking at what plans can we make? Okay. How can we come... Oh. There we go. How can we combine our forces? It's the Temperance card. How can we reestablish balance, combine our forces as a unified front, irregardless of what anyone says, daddy included? We've got the Two of Wands says that they're going to continue ruling over their particular environment. They've got plans. I think they're thinking about moving or buying another place. That is clearly in the works, but I don't see anything about any jail. I do have the Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords says they might come across some where they're going to have to talk to some legal representation. There could be some legal matters coming their way that they're going to be asked to talk about or testify. That's definitely going to be happening with them. A female, attorney, courts, whatever, is going to be looking at them for answering some of these questions regarding their father's organization. But I don't think Ivanka was too much involved in that. There was more of the brothers. Real quick, before I head out of here, let me take a quick look at what's going on with Betsy DeVos. It's another one that's been real, real quiet. Thank you guys for always watching. Thank you guys for being so super supportive. Thank you for all the new subscribers that have come our way. I love this family over here. I usually, you know, you guys have a right to your opinion, whether you agree or you disagree with me. It's just that I don't want you to feel any kind of way about Linda. When I like somebody, I'm very selective. And when I like somebody, really, I really like that person and I really will go to bat for that particular individual. So Betsy, what are you doing, Betsy DeVos? Yeah, I haven't heard her mention anything around in here either, in town. I think they're in Holland, Michigan, which is a little bit south. Actually, my husband works in Holland. It's like a tech capital down there. You guys don't even have any idea. Betsy DeVos. Betsy DeVos. She's feeling good. Okay, she really is. She's got the Nine of Cups. She's got everything that she's dreamed of. She's got, let me move my finger so you can see. She's got the Nine of Cups. However, if you take a look at the shadow in the back, she is being watched. She's not gotten away scot-free like she thinks. She's got the Nine of Cups. It's almost like that's a wish card, right? I've gotten everything I want. I'm satisfied. I'm happy. I got the cups. I'm emotions. I'm feeling good in what I'm doing. And yet, she's being watched for sure. get my screen back on. In addition, here we have the King of Wands. She's like the King of Wands, so that is a very powerful individual. She's got like a clique or a crew that really look to her in everything that she does, that are going to support her, and she's going to continue going on doing more business. If she got this particular money that's been reported, she's going to invest it in more businesses, and she's going to be back out there dipping and dodging in education. There she is, trying to be the helpful person, and she's got an immature thought. One thing that Betsy DeVos doesn't know is education, okay? Trust me on that. I've seen some of her things. But she wants to be back out there still contributing and everything else. Still, here she is. That's the High Priestess. Still someone trying to work in the traditional way, in the education field. This deals with education, traditional government. So I wouldn't be surprised if she tries to do something here. Maybe not necessarily on a state governmental level, but something to do back again with the education field. So she's not doing too much, but enjoying whatever she got from the situation when she was in office. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I enjoy you so much. I love your comments. I try to get to them, answer them as much as I can. Have a wonderful Saturday. It's a little bit gloomy over here. I don't know how it is over your way, but it's a little touch gloomy. I think they were supposed to get a little rain today and tomorrow. But anyways, the next time I see you, I'm going to vlog my vacation a little bit. I hope that works out good. All right. I love you guys so much. Thank you. Bye.